Hi everyone, my name's Rina. Some of you may possibly have heard of me. I work with a lot of young Catholic adults actually, and we do lots of fun things like going on pilgrimages and retreats and meeting up, and we've got a WhatsApp group going, so all sorts. So when you're a bit older, you know, join us. I'm sure you'll be able to find out where I am. Well, I've got a really fantastic part of the Bible to read, really, really important for you all, and it's actually about the coming of the Holy Spirit. This is chapter 94 of the Age of the Church in Need Children's Bible. So I'm going to read it through first and think about it as I'm reading it, and then afterwards I'm going to do a little meditation with you to try and help you to understand more what this reading is about, because this is incredibly important for all of us. So chapter 94. God's new people, the Church of Jesus Christ. On the day of Pentecost, all the disciples of Jesus, both men and women, as well as Mary, his mother, were gathered together in the same house. They were waiting for the Helper, whom Jesus had promised them. Then suddenly there came from heaven a roaring sound, like a mighty wind. It filled the whole house. Tongues of fire appeared and descended upon each one of them. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit. They praised God, and they praised his Son, Jesus Christ. Many people from distant lands had come to Jerusalem for the feast. A large crowd thronged in front of the house where the disciples were staying. They were all filled with awe, for each of them heard the disciples of Jesus speaking in his own language. They were perplexed and asked each other, "What does this mean?" Then Peter began to speak. He called out, "Listen to me. I will explain it to you. What the prophet Joel foretold in the name of God is being fulfilled here and now. At the end of time, God pours out his Spirit on all mankind. Remember Jesus of Nazareth. He came by the will of God and did the deeds of God. You witness this yourselves. God gave his only Son. You accused him and had him condemned by the Romans. He died on the cross, but God raised him up from the dead. We are all his witnesses. God has exalted him. He is the Messiah." The words of Peter went to the hearts of many people. They asked, "Brothers, what are we to do?" Peter replied, "Change your lives. Be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins. Then he will send you the Holy Spirit." Many listened to Peter and were baptized. That one day, 3,000 people joined the community of Jesus Christ.
Hi, hello again, everyone. I've brought you down from the right down here to the seashore. I imagine a lot of you love beaches and love being in the sea. We're actually at freshwater bay on the Isle of Wight. Very beautiful. Behind me there's quite a lot of people doing surfing. That's fantastic. But what I want to do, this is not about me, this is about you, and it's really important that you understand the reading we've just had. We're talking about the Holy Spirit. This is actually Jesus' presence with us now. And to understand that, I just want to take you back to the reading, and I want you to try and imagine that you're in that upper room with the disciples and with Mary. And I think you need to think back to what's happened, because Jesus has been crucified very cruelly on a cross. He's died. You know, everybody's really upset. Inconsolable, in fact. I mean, imagine if your mummy or daddy died, how you'd feel. And that's how the disciples felt after the lesson. But some of the disciples have seen Jesus, they say. Mary Magdalene has seen Jesus, and Peter and John, they have seen Jesus. But, you know, know, if somebody told you that someone you saw had died and was dead, you would sort of think, oh, I think you're just imagining it. So that's how people felt. They thought, you know, is this real? So what happens in this story is, you know, they're really scared, and the disciples are thinking, oh, any moment Romans or the Pharisees and Sanhedrin, somebody is going to arrive and they're going to arrest them and they're going to kill them. They're going to do the same to them as they did to Jesus. So they're sitting in the upper room, probably having a meal, and they're feeling really, really, really scared. So I want you to imagine that you're one of the disciples or you're Mary, and just think how you might feel in that situation. So you're sitting there and you're feeling really terrible, and then all of a sudden, something absolutely miraculous. And what happens is the Holy Spirit comes, and we can't really understand the Holy Spirit. We think of the Holy Spirit as perhaps a dove, a peace, or the Holy Spirit as a wind or a fire, all sorts of ideas. But the Holy Spirit is, to me, is like an energy, and it's an energy that can fill you. And I think if you imagine yourself in that story and you think of being transformed from being really, really upset to suddenly being filled with energy, with a joy, and such a joy that it makes you go out of that room and just yell at anybody, Jesus loves me, Jesus is alive, I believe in him. That's what the disciples experienced on that day, this incredible joy, because they knew Jesus was with them, because the Holy Spirit was with them. So that's what this story is about, really. It's about Jesus still being with us in our world today, still being living there in our hearts, in our minds, and actually helping us to go out into the world and to tell people about him, to tell people how much he loves him. Anyway, thank you for being with me. I hope that's helped you with the story. You know, maybe read it again and try and imagine yourself how you would feel if something like that happened. Okay, anyway, I'll look forward to maybe seeing you again sometime. So.